in your area. Every time I went to Southern California, he's always being around and so nice and welcoming and everything. We did a very nice course in his club.
Yes.
I don't know if you remember, like already maybe 7 years or 6 years ago. And I'm looking forward to go back there in Southern California.
I can't wait. I can finally meet in person, and we'd love to have you back. And I know some people who are on right now who actually were at that along with Nick. So
perfect.
A lot of good stuff. I'm excited. So again, thank you so much, sir, for joining me today.
You're welcome.
How are things out there in Florida for you?
Well, we've been now closed to the club for like maybe almost four weeks because once we had to close in Spain, we also closed it here, and the people here, the members and everyone, was looking at me like if I was completely crazy and coming from another planet, and they were saying I was exaggerating and I should not be that way. But I leave this through China. We closed in China in January, and then we had to close early March in Spain. So I said, well, this is going to arrive. So, and then we closed here also, I think, the week of the 9th of March. So 1 week before the everything started to be big alarm here. So, but after that, everybody had to close, and we just follow up the orders, and we have some kids still in Barcelona and as well here that they couldn't fly, like for example kids from Italy, that the situation there was terrible, or kids from Japan or from places like was already in a big mess. So the kids, they, as soon as this happened that week, we prepared to go with the school, everything online. So, and that has been an incredible experience because the teachers are able to give the lessons online. So it's not like they give them words or essays to do. It's right. Just that they, because there's a small community, the classes are very small, they manage to do the classes online. And we believe that the program is going to go through and they're not going to lose some time, because what the people is finding out that in online, the people go slower. But when you have the classes, it doesn't go as slow. So that part is good. The kids are going to finish the year well, and on the study side. So that's an added plus for the program. And on the other side, we just try to share some of the exercising for the kids that are at home. We put in some videos every 2 days for them to do physical modules and tennis modules, and bring a bit of knowledge to the people that they have a lot of time at home, and keep improving, you know. Like this is, I think, a great time to improve, because there's so much to share. And today I went on this talk from Andy Murray and Djokovic, and they say interesting things. So I think it's very good that everybody's sharing their inside, their inner part, and I think that it can give you also a part that normally we don't have time to explore.
Right. No, you're absolutely right. And I've actually gone on your academy's website, and I was doing some of these little things with my students, and I was really impressed with the Active and Strong series that you're doing on YouTube. So I'd encourage all of our viewers to check that out. It's not your typical, you know, shadow stroke for an hour. It's very specific, and there's a purpose behind it. So.
Oh, thank you so much, and they can sign to the YouTube channel from Sanchez Casal.
Okay.
And they can get all the material there, and we are not charging for anything, and we believe that is going to help everyone, and we have to keep the level up. So, and we're going to put more things on, and also talking about the dreams and about the change of exercises, and for the people to see it from another point of view.
Right. That's awesome. Those are really, really good episodes that I've seen. Very technical, very applicable.
Mm-hmm.
Even if it's just a rainy day.
Yeah.
it's very good.
Also, well, those are things. Also, we try to bring things that they help us. So, like for example, the exercise, this one with the snake. Like for me, when I was young, like my coach used to tell me, you have to try to go as high as possible to try to do the hand here. But I was serving more, you know, like more the stereotype from a club, and I was not seeing it, and he made me watch videos from the super servers at the time, that they were incredible servers like Corrin and Denton and those guys, but he was not clicking on me. But then because of this situation with the training, I remember one day doing sales with my friend that was the same level as me. And I saw him do this, you know, like this little whip and this little snake movement. And then I said, well, if he does it and does it so easy and so smooth, why I cannot do it? So I start to copy him and it clicked. And then I start to serve, and myself was really, really productive in my game, because I was able to serve first serve or second serve with a lot of topspin or a slice. So a lot of mix on the serve. And that's thanks to seeing my friend next to me. So sometimes the model is not in the super player. Right. Obviously, if you are able to copy Federer, you're gonna be in good shape, you know, because it's not like so easy. But sometimes to copy the best player is the most difficult, you know. And sometimes the model you have it next to you.
Yes, absolutely. Well, I also wanted to congratulate you. You know, you had some good news recently at your academy. I just posted a little bit here that you guys were able to reopen the doors.
That is very important for everyone, that we live in this lockdown and not be able to go to the club. And so we closed in China on the 22nd of January. We were closed for 8.5 weeks, and after 9 weeks, we were able to restart the program. With some conditions,
right?
The coaches had to go 2 weeks before. They were almost, it was an adventure to go to China with all the problems. So not almost, they say the people were saying to them, and say, "You crazy? You cannot go there. Everybody is dying." It's like if now, no, let's go to USA. No one wants to come here because we are in the worst moment. No, but the coaches flew there and they went the 14 days and they start the work. Another two coaches went in the meantime. So now we have 4 coaches working and about 23 players this week. So we've been working there for 3 weeks after 9 weeks. So we are 3 months on from the day that we had the lockdown. And we are already working on that with those quarantines and 14 days. So everybody who wants to move there, they have the 14 days. Now for the local people, this week they start to let them come without doing the quarantine. So if we take the same model, that means that if we started the lockdown here on the second week of March, we are the first week, second week of April, we have to wait probably one more month and 1 or 2 more weeks to be able to start the operations, and then slowly, and depending the type of operation that you do, and then you're going to be able to bring people local or nationally or so. I think the biggest challenge, like now in China, they close the borders again because they don't want foreigners to bring the virus again. So for international programs like ours, it's going to take a bit longer than a normal club that has the people on site, you know. But everyone has the advantages and disadvantages, depending on the type of public that they have.
Okay. And I also want to, you know, I know you're obviously originally from Spain. Your academy's in Barcelona. How is your family doing? Is everyone safe?
Yeah, unfortunately, my family, my mother is 85 now, she's fine, and my brothers and my sisters are all good. I have one brother and one sister in Barcelona, and another sister here close by in Arantxa, is in Miami. And so I know that she's also well, and most of the people, we need to have with all the people that works and plays in Barcelona or here, we didn't have any case, which is very fortunate. and not I didn't have any close person, but it's so tough, this movement with this moment that we are living, with so many people suffering because of their siblings and their families and their grandparents and so going away from us. So it's I hope that they find some cure very fast, and hopefully for next year we have a vaccine to stop this thing, because this is a nonsense, and no one expected this. And doesn't matter how you are, if you are a good person or bad person, it's the same for everyone. And so it's such a pity that we have to live through this. But like in anything, we have to become better and just take advantage from the adversity and come out in a better state.
Yes, absolutely. Well, I'm glad to hear all that. I'm glad to hear family is safe and healthy, and slowly, hopefully, we get back on the court soon. But in a safe way. So I wanted to kind of break it down and ask some questions, if you don't mind, about number one, your playing background, experience, playing history, and then transitioning to being a huge success in coaching, and then also establishing your academy. So I typically like to start with everyone's origin story, and lots of people know yours as far as dominating the tennis world for one of the top players for Spain in the 80s and 90s, being such a successful doubles player both on the men's and the mixed side, and playing and training such legendary players. Taking you back to your professional days and leading up to all those successes, what's the message that you would send juniors as they're aspiring to be, what's the message you send to your academy kids, and I have some of my students on right now. What's the message that you would give as they're aspiring to be collegiate players, professional players? What's kind of a breakdown? Because I know you're four pillars, and those are huge, and I'd love for you to talk about those, but if you would just expand on that.
Well, for me, at the end, is everything is about the your inner strength. So you can, they say, if you have a talent, so and then you want to explore the talent and to arrive to the best that you can be. But I think that there is a special talent inside that most of the people that does well in whatever they do in their lives, they have, like it's something like in whatever they do, they put the passion. And the passion is like the fire, it's like to try to do the best that you can do. And it's like if I am here and I'm not trying to tell you something to inspire or to make a difference, it will be normal. So, but maybe I tell you something that I inspire the students or my students. And for me, when I talk to my ex-players like Murray or Dimitrov or these guys, Kuznetsova, Arantxa, or these people, they don't talk to me about the forehand or about the tactic or about. They talk to me always about hard work, about discipline, about very basic values that we all would like to have. Like, I'm sure that when you hire someone from your club, you want that they have those values, that they are committed, that they put the passion, that they make a difference in whatever they do, even when they clean the courts, So when you get that, it becomes easier to come out from difficult situations and difficult moments. So for me, if with someone that you work or with someone that you have done, you just have the passion. And for me,
in your area, every time I went to Southern California, he's always being around and so nice and welcoming and everything. We did a very nice course in his club.
Yes.
I don't know if you remember. Like already maybe 7 years or 6 years ago, and I'm looking forward to go back there in Southern California.
I can't wait. I can finally meet in person, and we'd love to have you back. And I know some people who are on right now who actually were at that along with Nick. So
perfect.
A lot of good stuff. I'm excited. So again, thank you so much, sir, for joining me today.
You're welcome.
How are things out there in Florida for you?
Well, we've been now closed to the club for like maybe almost four weeks, because once we had to close in Spain, we also closed it here, and the people here, the members and everyone, was looking at me like if I was completely crazy and coming from another planet, and they were saying I was exaggerating and I should not be that way. But I leave this through China. We closed in China in January, and then we had to close early March in Spain. So I said, well, this is going to arrive. So, and then we closed here also, I think, the week of the 9th of March. So 1 week before the everything started to be big alarm here. So, but after that, everybody had to close, and we just follow up the orders, and we have some kids still in Barcelona and as well here that they couldn't fly, like for example kids from Italy, that the situation there was terrible, or kids from Japan or from places like was already in a big mess. So the kids, they, as soon as this happened that week, we prepared to go with the school, everything online. So, and that has been an incredible experience because the teachers are able to give the lessons online. So it's not like they give them works or essays to do. It's just that they, because there's a small community, the classes are very small, they manage to do the classes online. And we believe that the program is going to go through and they're not going to lose some time, because what the people is finding out that in online the people go slower, but when you have the classes it doesn't go as slow. So that part is good. The kids are going to finish the year well, and on the study side. So that's an added plus for the program. And on the other side, we just try to share some of the exercising for the kids that are at home. We put in some videos every 2 days for them to do physical models and tennis models, and bring a bit of knowledge to the people that they have a lot of time at home, and keep improving, you know. Like this is, I think, a great time to improve, because there's so much to share. And today I went on this talk from Andy Murray and Djokovic, and they say interesting things. So I think it's very good that everybody's sharing their inside, their inner part, and I think that it can give you also a part that normally we don't have time to explore.
Right. No, you're absolutely right, and I've actually gone on your academy's website, and I was doing some of these little things with my students, and I was really impressed with the active and strong series that you're doing on YouTube. So I'd encourage all of our viewers to check that out. It's not your typical, you know, shadow stroke for an hour. It's very specific, and there's a purpose behind it. So.
Oh, thank you so much. And they can sign to the YouTube channel from Sanchez Casal, okay. And they can get all the material there, and we are not charging for anything, and we believe that is going to help everyone, and we have to keep the level up. So, and we're going to put more things on, and also talking about the dreams and about the change of exercises, and for the people to see it from another point of view.
Right. That's awesome. Those are really, really good episodes that I've seen. Very technical, very applicable. Mm-hmm. Even if it's just a rainy day.
Yeah.
It's very good.
Also, those are things. Also, we try to bring things that they help us. So, like for example, the exercise, this one with the snake. Like for me, when I was young, like my coach used to tell me, you have to try to go as high as possible to try to do the hand here. But I was serving more, you know, like more the stereotype from a club, and I was not seeing it. And he made me watch videos from the from the super servers at the time, that they were incredible servers like Corrin and Denton and those guys, but it was not clicking on me. But then because of this situation with the training, I remember one day doing sales with my friend that was the same level as me. And I saw him do this, you know, like this little whip and this little snake movement. And then I said, well, if he does it and does it so easy and so smooth, why I cannot do it? So I start to copy him and it clicked. And then I start to serve, and myself was really, really productive in my game, because I was able to serve first serve or second serve with a lot of topspin or a slice. So a lot of mix on the serve. And that's thanks to seeing my friend next to me. So sometimes the model is not in the super player. Right. Obviously, if you are able to copy Federer, you're gonna be in good shape, you know, because it's not like so easy. But sometimes to copy the best player is the most difficult, you know. And sometimes the model you have it next to you.
Yes, absolutely. Well, I also wanted to congratulate you. You had some good news recently at your academy. I just posted a little bit here that you guys were able to reopen the doors.
That is very important for everyone, that we live in this lockdown and not be able to go to the club. And so we closed in China on the 22nd of January. We were closed for 8.5 weeks, and after 9 weeks, we were able to restart the program. With some conditions,
right?
The coaches had to go 2 weeks before. They were almost, it was an adventure to go to China with all the problems. So not almost, they say the people were saying to them and said, "You crazy? You cannot go there. Everybody is dying." It's like if now, no, let's go to USA. No one wants to come here because we are in the worst moment. No, but the coaches flew there, and they went the 14 days and they start the work. Another two coaches went in the meantime. So now we have four coaches working and about 23 players this week. So we've been working there for 3 weeks after 9 weeks. So we are 3 months on from the day that we had the lockdown. And we are already working on that with those quarantines and 14 days. So everybody who has to move there, they have the 14 days. Now for the local people, this week they start to let them come without doing the quarantine. So if we take the same model, that means that if we started the lockdown here on the first week, second week of March, we are the first week, second week of April, we have to wait probably one more month and 1 or 2 more weeks to be able to start the operations. And then slowly, depending the type of operation that you do, and then you're going to be able to bring people local or nationally or so. I think the biggest challenge, like now in China, they close the borders again because they don't want foreigners to bring the virus again. So for let's say for international programs like ours, it's going to take a bit longer than a normal club that has the people on site, you know. But everyone has the advantages and disadvantages depending on the type of public that they have.
Okay. And I also want to, you know, I know you're obviously originally from Spain, your academy's in Barcelona. How is your family doing? Is everyone safe?
Yeah, fortunately. My family, my mother is 85 now, she's fine, and my brothers and my sisters are all good. I have one brother and one sister in Barcelona, and another sister here close by in Arantxa, is in Miami. And so I know that she's also well, and most of the people, we need to have, with all the people that works and plays in Barcelona or here, we didn't have any case, which is very fortunate. And I didn't have any close person, but it's so tough, this movement with this moment that we are living, with so many people suffering because of their siblings and their families and their grandparents and so going away from us. So it's I hope that they find some cure very fast, and hopefully for next year we have a vaccine to stop this thing, because this is a nonsense, and no one expected this. And doesn't matter how you are, if you are a good person or bad person, it's the same for everyone, and so it's such a pity that we have to live through this. But like in anything, we have to become better and just take advantage from the adversity and come out in a better state.
Yes, absolutely. Well, I'm glad to hear all that. I'm glad to hear family is safe and healthy, and slowly, hopefully, we get back on the court soon. But in a safe way. So I wanted to today. I wanted to kind of break it down and ask some questions, if you don't mind. About number one, your playing background, experience, playing history, and then transitioning to being a, you know, huge success in coaching, and then also establishing your academy. So I typically like to start with everyone's origin story, and lots of people know yours as far as dominating the tennis world, for, you know, in really top players for Spain in the 80s and 90s, being such a successful doubles player, both on the men's and the mixed side, and playing and training such legendary players. Taking you back to your professional days and leading up to all the successes, what's the message that you would send juniors as they're aspiring to be, you know, what's the message you send your academy kids, and I have some of my students on right now, what's the message that you would give as they're aspiring to be collegiate players, professional players? What's kind of a breakdown? Because I know your four pillars, and those are huge, and I'd love for you to talk about those, but if you would just expand on that.
Well, for me, at the end, is everything is about the your inner strength. So you can, they say, if you have a talent, so and then you want to explode the talent and to arrive to the best that you can be. But I think that there is a special talent inside that most of the people that does well in whatever they do in their lives, they have, you know, like it's something like in whatever they do, they put the passion. And the passion is like the fire, you know, it's like to try to do the best that you can do. And it's like if I am here and I'm not trying to tell you something to inspire or to make a difference, you know, it will be normal. So, but maybe I tell you something that I inspire the students or my students. And for me, when I talk to my ex-players like Murray or Dimitrov or these guys, Kuznetsova, Arantxa, or these people, they don't talk to me about the forehand or about the tactic or about. They talk to me always about hard work, about discipline, about very basic values that we all would like to have. Like, I'm sure that when you hire someone from your club, you want that they have those values, that they are committed, that they put the passion, that they make a difference in whatever they do, even when they clean the courts, you know. So when you get that it becomes easier to come out from difficult situations and difficult moments. So for me, if with someone that you work or with someone that you have done, you just have the passion. And for me, like,
in your area, every time I went to Southern California, he's always being around and so nice and welcoming and everything. We did a very nice course in his club.
Yes.
I don't know if you remember, like already maybe 7 years or 6 years ago. And I'm looking forward to go back there in Southern California.
I can't wait. I can finally meet in person, and we'd love to have you back. And I know some people who are on right now who actually were at that along with Nick. So
perfect.
A lot of good stuff. I'm excited. So again, thank you so much, sir, for joining me today.
You're welcome.
How are things out there in Florida for you?
Well, we've been now